Welcome to our ongoing coverage of CES 2022 here on the Cord Cutters News YouTube channel. We'll be sharing all the biggest streaming and cord cutting stories throughout the week so you can stay up to date on what you might expect for the coming year. And now for CES 2022, show organizers have been scrambling to keep the show running after a raft of companies opted out of in-person attendance due to COVID. But the show is still going on and we've still got news to cover. First up is Samsung, who shared its 2022 plans at a pre-CES briefing. And while those plans were a bit light on new hardware and tech, there are still some interesting tidbits to discuss. First off, Samsung's Neo QLED line of 4K and 8K TVs get some tweaks to improve brightness and contrast. One of the headlining changes is the backlight, which moves from 12-bit to 14-bit gradation. In short, that means the brightness can be adjusted through more than 16,000 levels of intensity compared to the previous 12-bit panel's 4,096 steps. That should theoretically allow for more precise brightness control. Elsewhere, the 2022 line of Neo QLED TVs adds something called Real Depth Enhancer, which attempts to use artificial intelligence to sharpen foreground objects to help them stand out better against the background. Samsung is also touting audio upgrades, including upward-firing speakers for improved surround sound. The company is also boasting about software improvements, including a new smart hub that adds sidebars for categories like media, gaming, and ambient. That last one essentially allows you to customize the screensaver experience. The gaming hub aims to centralize both console and cloud-based options into one location, including support for streaming services like Google Stadia and Nvidia's GeForce Now. A new Watch Together feature lets users set up multiple panels to have virtual watch parties on their TVs. Samsung says you just need to hook up a camera from a compatible smart device to connect with friends and family remotely. The company is also talking about the ability to browse, purchase, and display digital artwork through its new NFT platform. Now, NFTs, or non-fungible tokens, are a hot topic these days with some vocal parties both for and against, so it'll be interesting to see how Samsung actually approaches this. We shall see. The company's designer models like the Frame and MicroLED lines are also getting some updates. The Frame is getting a new anti-reflective screen that should add a more matte-like finish. The goal there is to make displayed artwork look more lifelike as opposed to the shiny gloss of earlier displays. And the MicroLED line is getting more pre-configured size options of 89, 101, and 110 inches. There's also a new smart monitor that comes in at 32 inches and features an included webcam. The smart monitor line is meant to appeal to work-from-home folks looking for displays that can be useful for both work and home. The new M8 model offers traditional computer monitor features, but with smart TV capabilities built right in. And last but not least, there is a new Eco remote that charges via solar power during the day and via radio waves at night. And if you're wondering what radio waves, well, from your Wi-Fi router for one. The new remote aims to offer easy charging of its internal battery without having to rely on disposable AA or AAA batteries, and it'll be interesting to see how it works in practice. So far, we don't have exact pricing or release dates for Samsung's new gear or its software features, but we'll be keeping an eye out for updates. And be sure to stay tuned to Cord Cutters News all week long as we cover all the top streaming and cord cutting stories from CES 2022. And if you like our coverage, be sure to hit those like and subscribe buttons. This is Philip Palermo, and we'll see you next time. Take care.